And the show goes on. This is Backstage Pass on Urban TV. Let's get into yet another event that took place last week, the week before, and still has another edition coming up. Thanks Brighties Friday, a great initiative that, if you ask me, should have been taken up by the university, which is to go out and try and get raw talent, creative talent from the university. But as you know, university is all about, university administration is all about academics and maybe some sports. So it's a great thing that Sprite came out and said, you know what, there's a lot of undiscovered, great, rich, raw talent at the university when it comes to DJs in particular. So what they did was they rolled out the program to go to all the different universities and try to get some of the hottest new budding DJs. And boy, oh boy, the journey has so far gone to a couple of universities across Uganda. And things are looking pretty good in terms of the talent that was found. Jemima joins me on the show today. Hi, Jemima.
Hi.
All right, great to have you on Urban.
Thank you. Good to see you too.
TSIF, Thanks Bright It's Friday. What is it all about?
So TSIF, it's Thanks Bright It's Friday.
Louder.
It's Thanks Bright It's Friday.
Yeah.
It's a university DJ campaign sponsored by Sprite. It's a university DJ campaign sponsored by Sprite. So we've gone to different universities. So far, we've gone to 9 universities.
Oh, cool.
Including Makerere University.
Yeah.
MOBS.
Yeah.
KIU. IUAA.
Yeah.
Mambarara,
yes.
Nkozi, Nkumba,
yeah.
Ndeje University, and we've so far got the best out of their DJs.
Now, last week you were at Makerere University.
Yes.
Earlier on, I was talking to the host of the show, that is Timothy Code, and you were telling me it was very explosive and very competitive.
Yeah, it was.
Was that true?
Yeah, it was. Of course, you know, university kids.
Yeah.
They're really, really competitive, and it was amazing. We got the best DJ, but it was very hard to get the best because they were all good.
Yeah.
So we had to go through our code, like voting.
Mm-hmm.
So the more votes you got,
yeah,
the more chances of you to win, and we got the best. And his name is Bar
Gavakov.
Yeah.
So you go into the university. What happens when you get to the campus?
We organize. We set up. We do our branding, Sprite branding.
Yeah.
We do a gaming experience, visual gaming.
You have a gaming experience, yeah.
Yeah, barber shop experience, so that you can get experiential haircuts.
Is are the haircuts free or?
Free.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, free.
Yeah.
Some universities we give out free sodas.
Yeah.
We give out free T-shirts.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we need our branding to be seen, and this is all promoting Sprite.
Uh huh.
Yeah, so we normally give out free things.
Great stuff. Now, you also have some DJs who usually headline the tours.
Yeah.
You've had the likes of Roger and Slick Stewart. You've had the likes of Cass Baby. And last weekend, you had Sir Aluda at Makerere University.
We've had Fame DJ.
Yes.
We are yet to have Nacelo the Don.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, you go around collecting all these raw DJs, upcoming talent from the universities. What happens to them after?
These DJs get a chance to interact with their celeb DJs.
Okay.
You know, all these university DJs look up to the big DJs we have in Uganda, like the ones you mentioned,
mm-hmm.
like Nacelo the Don, Saluda, Femme
yeah.
DJs, Luke Stewart and Roger,
mm-hmm.
and Cass Baby.
Yeah.
So they inspire them.
Yeah.
So when they get to the universities, they get to talk to them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they tell them, you did good here, you did bad here, so you can improve here.
Ah.
And then they're also going to get chance. Once you win,
yeah,
you're going to get chance. Now we got, so far you have 9 DJs.
Yes.
We're going to take them to, we have club raves coming up very soon.
Okay.
So we're going to try to create publicity for them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they'll be getting chance to
for build market. A name for themselves as well.
Yeah.
That's very important and very cool for somebody who's at university. I'm also just trying to DJ all of a sudden, so unfortunately, I lost my Makerere University ID, so I can't apply for Thanks Practice Friday. But thank you so much for joining us on the show, though.
Thank you, too. Thank you for having me.
In case you want to follow that action online, you can do so with their hashtag. That's TSIF. On we go with the show. It is Independence Month, and we have something special for you to take you back in time here on Backstage Pass. Take
Taking a look around, all I can do is be proud about being Ugandan, such a country that is beautifully gifted by nature. Welcome to Backstage Pass today on Independence Day as we celebrate being Ugandan. Now, the national celebrations are happening up north in Angulu, but today we take you on the opposite direction on Backstage Pass into Queen Elizabeth National Park with Lake Edward in the back. We're going to talk to a couple of people around here and find out what exactly it means to them to be Ugandan. Roger, 53 years of Uganda. What does it mean to you to be Ugandan?
Me being 53 or Uganda?
Well, we can have it that way as well.
Quickly, you know, there's a lot about this country that we are yet to appreciate. And sometimes we get locked in Kampala for, you know, we get brain jams in Kampala without realizing that, you know, we're gifted. We're gifted. And you just take a look around. Just look around there.
Drown me in your lies, and there's no way to breathe. And my walls are
Chams, how are you doing?
Good, how are you? I'm feeling so great.
All right, good. Of course we're feeling good because the weather's great around here, isn't it?
So fabulous. I mean, compared to the dust of Kampala, this is such a great place to be.
But it looks like this jacket came with some dust, but we're not going to ask about that.
It's a dusty green color.
I've had that reason before in high school when I never used to wash my stuff, but we won't talk about that.
No worries.
53 years of Uganda this year. As a Ugandan, we're going to ask you a couple of questions about Uganda to see if you have your knowledge together. Quickly, the two things that you find on the National Coat of Arms.
The Uganda Cob and there's cotton. And there is a crystal queen.
Ah, he's even giving us an extra one. Okay, great stuff. And with me, I have a gentleman who's being very patriotic at the moment. Great T-shirt, for starters.
Thank you.
I thought you were showing off your six-pack. Okay, yeah.
It's just one now. But later, maybe.
Three things on the coat of arms.
Cob, rivers, drum, cotton. I could go on.
I'm pretty much sure you've seen the Ugandan flag somewhere in your life. So we're going to ask you, what exactly one of the three colors symbolizes?
Black, which is for African, red, which is for blood, yellow, which is for the sunshine.
And just like that, we're done with the show for today. Happy Independence to you, and we sure hope you're very proud about being Ugandan.
And that right there was a throwback as we try to get you thinking about traveling around Uganda. It's the month of October, the month when we most especially celebrate what it means to be Ugandan. As we say goodnight from us here on Urban TV, thank you very much for me and the crew. You can keep in touch with us on social media at Urban TV Uganda, I beg your pardon, as well as my personal handle, that's at Denzel UD. Leaving you with a little something special that Urban TV is involved in. Check this out.
The reason we are here at Atmosphere is because we are actually launching the Europa Games, like officially doing our Europa promotion, and we want to actually make people get involved and end up traveling to Europe to watch Manchester or Arsenal live in action. And how awesome is that?
For the next 8 months, it's going to be exciting on Urban TV, and of course in partnership with the new home of football, Star Times. And I can't wait, you know, to travel with you guys to watch Arsenal and Manchester United. I hope Manchester United can go to the final, because I know Arsenal, we may actually take this trophy. So it's going to be November 6th, first trip, and the second trip is going to be 12th December. And imagine, you know, going and flying for free. You know, all you have to do is subscribe to Star Times. You know, 26,000 shillings you pay, watch, enjoy, get into the draw and win. Or simple, bet with BetCity, www.betcity.co.ug. Win. First of all, you win money. So if you bet Arsenal, whatever, which it doesn't have to be actually Arsenal, Manchester United games, can be anything. You can bet on dogs, whatever. You can win cash and then get in the draw and win a trip. And let's see how it goes, because, you know, the tickets might increase and maybe you fly with a friend. And, you know, we'll see how it goes.
Just won 100k courtesy of Bet City, and all I did was to register, become a new member on their website. Yeah, well, as my colleagues were betting with 1,000 shillings, who won as well. But man, the thing is real.